Now here we are to have a look at an Ibanez guitar, or Ibanez guitar, or Ibanezer guitar, depending on what part of the world you come from. And this is one of the Mylandstrom beasts, the AEG-10 Mark II. That's important, because there's a Mark I out there that you might find going about second-hand, and there are differences. But more of that later. What does it sound like? The basic sound. That's it just getting picked up through the mic. I'll come on to the pickup itself in a wee while. Now, as with all guitars, most of them sound fine in the first two or three frets, but what do they sound like as they go up the neck? Do they keep the tone, and importantly, do they keep the tuning? Very good. It tends to keep its tone, the intonation itself. It's very good. The saddle is a flat fingerboard, so you have a flat saddle. But unlike classical guitars, it's a constant height on both sides. It's been slanted back a wee bit more at the bass side to give the compensation needed to keep the intonation correct. Normally with classical guitars, it's at right angles to the strings, and then it's raised at the bass side, which actually makes things a little more awkward. This is a better arrangement. The neck itself is narrower than a classical guitar, wider than your electric or your acoustic guitar. It gives you just enough room to do the clever stuff. I do find that if I try to play classical style pieces on an electric or an acoustic, well, yeah, it works, but every so often there's a note that's not quite pure. It somehow it gets muffled slightly, and the wider neck gets rid of that problem. Now, it's a satin finish on the back. Oops. Satin finish on the back there. Gloss finish on the body. You've got a good set of machine heads, very pretty. You've got kind of perloid buttons on it there. Look very nice, but more importantly, they work well. When I got the guitar at first, the strings on it, well, they seemed all right, but there were one or two intonation problems. So I changed them quite quickly. What you have to bear in mind is that a guitar can actually be in storage. It can take 2 years to get from the factory to the retailer. So in that time, the strings, no matter how good they are, what good a make they are, they can deteriorate. So always a good idea to change your strings pretty early on in the game. Now, what does it sound like when you strum it? It's all very well talking about classical stuff, but what if we just want to have a folksy strum? There you are. Quite nice behind the voice if you want to do your Corey's idea of things. And if you want to do the classical stuff, nice balanced sound on it, not too deep. Now we'll come to the pickup, and the pickup on the side there. This is the main difference between this, the Mark II and the Mark I. The pickup's been completely changed. There didn't seem to be anything particularly wrong with the pickup on the Mark I. And although I don't have the Mark I anymore, I had one a couple of years back. I can't say that this is a great improvement, but equally it's not any worse. It's a perfectly good pickup. like all pickups for classical guitars, though, it suffers from the treble strings being a wee bit louder than the bass. The bass is always a bit weaker on the style of guitar. Not particularly Ibanez. It doesn't matter what make you go to, what pickup you use. Unless you've got a built-in mic, actual microphone in the guitar to restore the balance, you're always going to find the treble a wee bit louder than the bass. In a band situation, that doesn't really matter because there's a bass player. But if you're trying to do the solo classical guitarist bit, yeah, it can be a wee bit annoying. So the best recording solution is actually, as you'll hear in a moment, to use a mic and use the pickup as well. So all the controls are in the halfway position. You've got bass, middle, treble, and you have a phase switch and a built-in tuner, which is nice as well. The difference with the other pickup thing is one thing you've lost down there. You've only got a quarter-inch jack socket down there. On the previous version, you had that, but you had the Canon connector, the XLR connector, as well, which was handy, but they've dispensed with it on this one. They have, however, given you the satin neck, which the previous model didn't have. I do believe there's a natural finished version of this as well, but it's got a gloss neck, not a satin neck. So I went for the black, which is the disadvantage that you've got to clean it every day, because the minute you touch it, it'll leave a fingerprint, which under certain angles of light just means that your guitar looks manky all the time. Anyway, back to the pickup. There's a wee bit of reverb on the pickup coming through the mixing desks. I reckon you would be using that anyway. So what you're hearing now is pickup and microphone. Now I'll turn the microphone down, so all you're going to hear is the pickup, and then I'll footer with the three controls, and you'll hear the sound range that it gives. So there you are, the Ibanez. My reason for choosing this particular guitar really had nothing to do with the pickup itself. Just physically, I find this a nice size. It's a slightly narrower body than you would get in a normal classical guitar, and the feel of the neck is superior to, in my opinion, to a standard classical. So that's basically why I brought this one home from the store and not a conventional guitar. Only thing to remember is it doesn't have a scratch plate, so if you're tempted to use a plectrum, as someone has done on this guitar, a person who shall remain nameless but for the sake of argument we'll call it my son, it's left a few scratch marks on the varnish there. So if you are going to use a plectrum, best to buy a wee stick on the scratch plate. Don't get the see-through ones, the transparent ones, because if you leave any air bubbles, you can see the air bubble. They're a nightmare to get on right. You best to get one of the coloured ones for that. So there you go. If you want to hear the Mark One, a wee box will appear on the screen, and if you click on that will give you the link, I think, to my video of me playing Danny Boy. It's not a review, it's just me actually playing the guitar, but you can maybe hear the difference of the guitar, because it's recorded through the same mixing desk, which I've had for years.